my name is Hilda. I'm from Azuma Dojo Canada, and this is a 30-minute video for beginner stretching and introduction to yoga. So first I'm going to talk about the equipment. I have a mat here, but if you don't have a mat at home, you can use a big bath towel, something that you can sit on that is comfortable. And other thing that you can use as assistance if you are not very flexible and you're just beginning stretching, something like an old shirt or a long towel that's long enough that you can put around your foot and that pull on it so that you can get deeper into the stretches is all that you're going to need. Alright, so let's begin by sitting cross-legged, nice and comfortable. You can also put a cushion beneath your bum or an extra towel if you need to. So we'll begin with a seated meditation and just stack your spine nice and tall. Try to engage your abs. Bring the crown of your head towards the ceiling. And take deep breaths. So in through the nose. And out through the mouth. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, one more breath, inhale, exhale, let's begin, inhale raising your hands to the sky, exhale palms together, bring it back to your chest, also called heart center. Next, we're going to lower one hand to the floor. Inhale, the other hand straight up. And exhale, reaching towards the side. Inhale. Exhale. Try to make sure that both your sit bones are flat on the floor. One more breath. Inhale. Then we exhale, come back to center. And we'll do the other side. Inhale, arm up. And exhale, reach to the side. So feel your ribs opening, finding space with every breath. One more big inhale. And exhale, come back to center. Next, we're going to place one hand directly behind us near your back. Then that'll be very far. The other hand comes over the front knee. I'm using my left arm behind and the right in the front. And an inhale, twist. And exhale, I'm going to push your hand against your knee. Just try to stay tall. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, exhale, one more breath, inhale, and exhale, come back to center. So next breath, we're going to inhale, place the hand behind us, and exhale, push the twist, looking behind. Inhale again. Exhale. Try to let your body relax. Inhale. And exhale. Last breath. Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center. Very nice. So next we're going to release that legs and take them up farther in front. So you're going to make a bit of a diamond shape. And reaching forward towards your feet or your ankles, whatever you can get. You're going to pull yourself forward, making sure your back is straight, finding length. And lower down ever so slightly, as far as you can go, while keeping the back straight. You're going to inhale. And exhale. Inhale. We're going to curl our backs this time. So inhale. Let your body curl and kind of fold forward, bringing your head towards your feet. And inhale. Exhale. And don't worry if you can't get that far down. As far as you can. Inhale. Exhale. One last breath, inhale. Exhale. Next inhale to push ourselves back up. And we're going to bring our feet closer to our bodies. And in as close as you can. And we're going to do the same thing here. So we're going to grab our legs and I'm going to pull our bodies forward, keeping our back straight. And then hinging forward as long as we can while keeping that length in the back. So you feel it higher in your back than if you're curling it. So keeping our back straight, inhale. Exhale. One more breath, inhale. Exhale. Next we're going to curl, inhale to curl. And exhale, fold yourself forward as far as you can go. And feel the difference in your back. Below, much lower down to the tailbone. You can use your elbows to push your knees wide. One more breath here, inhale. Exhale. One more breath, inhale. Exhale. Inhale to release, coming back up. And we're going to take our legs in front of us. So I'm going to turn to the side so that it's easier for you to see what I'm doing. And here you can grab your towels. We're going to start with a forward fold. So with our legs straight in front, you can give your ankles a bit of a twist. In case you got a bit stiff earlier. So next with our back stacked up straight, inhale, hands up. And as we exhale, then reach forward with our hands, trying to grab our feet. Keeping the back straight and pulling forward. Now if you can't actually reach your feet, this is where you're going to use your towel or shirt, whatever you have. Put them around the bottom of your foot and just pull yourself forward this way. That way you keep a nice straight back. I'm going to inhale here and exhale. One more breath, inhale and exhale. Next we're going to crawl, inhale and exhale. Bring the body closer to your legs, bringing the head down. And you can always adjust your grip. You can come back farther. And pull more on your shirt or towel. Breath here. And do tuck in your abs. See if you can suck it in. And get lower onto your leg. Good. Inhale. Close, rise up. And exhale to release. Very good. Now we're going to do another twist. We're going to bring the knee up and put it on the other side of our leg. So starting first off, we're just going to pull the knee towards the center of our body. One hand behind our back, sitting tall. And this is a very nice stretch for the muscle here. So we're going to inhale and exhale. Again, inhale. Exhale. Now to deepen the twist, we're going to inhale, put our elbow in front of our knee. As we exhale, and push on our elbow. You can stay this way or extend the arm if you like. Looking behind. Inhale. Exhale. And releasing the waist. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Two, inhale. And exhale. One more breath, inhale. And exhale. And I'm gonna deepen the twist again. Placing our elbow over our knee. Good push as we exhale. Or you can straighten the arm. Try to make sure your shoulders don't come all the way up like I was doing earlier. So inhale. Exhale, twist. Looking behind you. One more breath, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale to release. Coming back to center. And we'll release those legs. Now I'm going to take it wide. As wide as we can. And you're going to reach forward as far as you can go. Maybe it's here, maybe it's a lot farther, all the way down. If you can't go very far, one nice trick that I like is to just place your hands down very close to you and lower as if you're doing a push-up. That way you can maintain your balance and you can let your hips roll forward, you're using gravity to pull yourself down. So wherever you are, give that a try. And we're going to inhale, exhale, releasing ourselves to the floor. Two, inhale, exhale. Again, if you can't go very far, stay here. Inhale, exhale. And one more breath, inhale. Exhale. Good. Inhaling to push ourselves back up. Now we're going to turn our body. So make sure you're as square as you can be towards your knee and your leg as you're facing it. And you can also grab your towel in case you can't reach. Basically, we're going to fold open onto our legs. So we're going to stretch forward. Inhale. Exhale, pull. Do try to keep your shoulders down, pulling in with your elbows. Flex your body, flexing the foot. Two, inhale. Exhale. And three, this time we're going to curl. Inhale, and fold forward. As far as we can. Inhale, exhale. Next, we're going to twist, opening up to the side. So you can place your towel into one hand. And we're going to open it up. You can put your elbow onto the floor, giving you extra stability. And look towards the ceiling, raising your hand up into the sky. And reaching far. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Make sure that you open your chest towards the front. It's better to be having the chest open than scrunched and reaching down. So even if you're up here, as long as your chest is towards the outside, that's much better. One more breath here, inhale. As we exhale, we're going to push ourselves back towards the center and release that leg. And we're going to go for the other side. So, twisting our bodies, and I'm bringing my shirt over. And you're going to stay tall first, reaching forward, pulling yourself. If you're not using anything, if you can grab your foot or even the ankle, that's also good. Let me turn around so you can actually see what I'm doing. So reaching the ankle if you don't have a towel that you can't reach, that's also good. Or flexing the feet. Okay, inhale. Exhale. Two.
leg as possible. Inhale. And you'll find that your arms can reach a lot further the lower you are. And exhale. So next up, you'll inhale.
And putting using, you can also put your hand on the inside of your leg to open your chest out and up, reaching up. And exhale. Reaching far as you can. You want to feel the stretch on the outside of your ribs. Staying here, inhale. And exhale. Try to relax into the stretch. Inhale. And exhale. Next breath, we're going to come back. Inhale. And push ourselves back up to center. Exhale. Beautiful. Alright, now we're going to move on to our hands and knees. And here it's very important to make sure that your hands are beneath your shoulders so that your arm is perpendicular to the floor. And same with your knees. So the legs should be right below the hips. And we're going to start with something called cat and cow. So the cat position is actually when you're curling. And then believe the cat is arching. Or cow is arching. Well, one or the other. I forget at the moment. So we're going to do this action. So starting here, we're going to inhale to arch. And exhale to curl.
Inhale, arch.
Push your belly down as you're arching. Exhale, curl.
Pulling the belly up. Pushing down on your knees and hips. One more. Inhale to arch.
And exhale to curl. Very good. Now I'm going to move into a cross. So, depending on how strong you're feeling, you can do the full version, which is putting your weight on one hand and one knee. So I'm going to start with my right hand and left knee, lifting the left hand and right leg up, going across, and holding it here. So if that's too difficult for you, you can always stick with just the leg coming up. Don't have to lift the hand. Or alternatively, you can just try the hands. So find something that works for you, and we'll continue here. So we're going to inhale, letting the hands and feet rise up. Exhale. The hold. So remember with your cat and cow, how you're arching and curling. This is neutral, so we're right in the middle in between. Holding here. Inhale, exhale. One more breath, reach, inhale, exhale. Last inhale, and exhale, bring our hands back and our feet. Switching sides, and making sure our core is strong. Engaging the abs makes this a whole lot easier. So we're putting the hand weight on the opposite side now. So left hand, right knee, lifting the other. So inhale to lift. Exhale, reach. Holding here. Inhale. Exhale. Three, inhale. Exhale. Four, inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Replace the hands and the knees. position called child's pose. You'll hear this a lot in yoga. So all you do is bring your butt back towards your heels and relax your body into the floor. So this is a great position to get into if you're tired. In any yoga class, if you take child's pose, the teacher will know that you're taking a break. Alternately, you can also bring the hands behind you. So if you're doing a lot of push-ups, planking, and your shoulders are tired, bring the arms back so you can relax them. Turn your head to the side. And this is child's pose. Coming back into the hands and knees. We are going to move into planking now. So all we're going to do is make sure again that our hands are beneath our shoulders, and we're going to take our feet back, tap toes, and you're going to engage everything. So engage the core, so making the abs tight, squeezing the thighs, squeezing the butt cheeks together, and pushing the heels back. This will make sure our legs are tense. And we're gonna hold this for 5 breaths. If you need to rest, go ahead and take it. So here we go for 1, inhale. Exhale. 2, inhale. Exhale. 3, inhale. Exhale. 4, inhale. Exhale. Last one, 5, inhale. And exhale. Bend our elbows and lower ourselves to the mat. All the way down. And we're going to flip our toes over so that the top of your feet is on the floor. Next, we're going to move into upward dog and its variations. So first, I'll show you what upward dog looks like. And you'll hear this a lot in yoga classes as well. Basically, pushing the tops of your feet on the floor, everything lifts up. As you reach forward, head is back, or up. So notice how the knees and the thighs are off the floor. This is upward dog. I'm going to lower. Now that may be too much. And when you're doing your practice after a 30-minute session, it can be very much. So the alternate is cobra, in which point your thighs and your knees stay on the floor. And hands are still beneath the shoulders, so just coming down after the plank. And turn over, and you just push up from here. It's a great stretch for the lower back. Again, reaching up with the crown of your head. Let the legs stay on the floor. So I'm going to lower down. The last one, if cobra is also coming, you can take a sphinx position, which, like the sphinx, you're going to have your elbows on the floor, hands in front of you. And it's much more of an upper back stretch. So your lower back won't be engaged in this one, but it is a lot easier than the others. So if you hear upward dog, you can always pick cobra or sphinx. And then you're going to inhale as you get into the pose. And exhale. If you're holding. And I'm going to lower back down. So those are some basic yoga poses that you will hear. The next one I'm going to introduce you to is Chaturanga. So we're going to push back into plank. And from here, Chaturanga is known as a staff pose. So your body is very straight, and as you lower yourself down and your body is horizontal to the floor, this is the position. So it's very difficult to hold, so we won't do it in this video, but this is Chaturanga, so if you hear it, all you have to do is take the plank, come down,
And just come all the way down to the mat. And afterwards, you'll most likely hear 99% of the time upward dog. So Chaturanga generally follows that.
So at which point you can come into cobra or sphinx.
Or if you like to challenge it, full upward dog.
Okay.
So, and after this, you can come back down, all the way down to the mat. And then tuck your toes under. And then push up back into plank. Easiest transition for me. And then you're gonna lift your hips and pushing your hands away from the floor. Bring your heels back and down. Until you reach up into the triangle. And feel free to adjust. Very hard to pin it right the first time around. So find a position where you have a straight back. And you're pushing your butt back also, like you're pushing it against the wall behind you. Imagine imaginary wall that you're going to bring your butt against. And here we have downward dog. So your gaze, where you're looking, can be at the knees or at your toes. And take a few breaths here. So if you're finding a lot of pressure on your wrist or your hands, adjust so that you put more weight on your legs, because you shouldn't have too much weight on your hands. A lot of people go really far forward. Just ease it back, whether you're pushing your hands away or stepping forward with your feet, until you can actually put weight to the back part. So you want your weight in the center. And you do need to tuck in your lower belly and lengthen that way. So it's really great for lower abdominals. So we've been here for a while. So let's take one more breath. Inhale. Exhale. And next we're going to look up. We're finding that space between our hands. We're just going to walk towards it. It's okay if your hands come off the floor. And from here we're going to try forward fold. So that's bringing your body and your head as close to your legs as possible as you exhale. The first time around, you can grab the back of your leg, give yourself some assistance. But it doesn't really matter if you're in the middle of a sequence that you can't get all the way down or that. And next we're going to rise up, so putting weight on your heels and your feet. We're going to slowly rise upwards. And once you're standing, raise your hands towards the sky. Inhale. And exhale, hands back to heart center. So from here, you pretty much have all the moves you need in order to do a sun salutation, which is one of the most basic sequences that you will find. So we're going to do one of them here, very slowly. So standing, and make sure your feet can be about hip length apart. And you want to make sure everything is stacked up nicely so that your weight is over your hips, over your knees, over your feet. The crown is towards the sky. And as you have your hands to the side, this is also called mountain pose or tadasana, which is something that you'll see in a few sequences. This is a starting position. So we can begin in tadasana. Inhale, lifting our heads so that our back is
go all the way down to the mat. As we inhale, make sure you flip the toes under. And upward dog or cobra or sphinx. And exhale, coming back down to the mat. Tuck the toes.
Inhale, push back up. And lifting the hips. Exhale, push all the way back into downward dog. Take a breath here. Inhale. Exhale. And our next inhale, we're going to look up. And as we exhale, walk ourselves back towards the center. And take another breath. Inhale, and then exhale, forward fold. Next, we're going to rise up. Weight on the legs. Inhale.
Hands into the air. Exhale, hands back to our center. So, that was your first sequence in yoga. I hope you enjoyed it and a bit of our stretching. So thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll be able to post more videos in the future, and let me know if there are things that you'd like to try out. So thank you very much. Again, this is Hilda from Azuma Dojo Canada.